I did not know this guy loves the beach. Every time, like now, when I'm even driving up, just like the dog park, he sees it miles away and he's like going crazy in the car. You know what that means? We're going to the beach every time, every chance I get, that means. It's the day after Christmas. I am gonna shut up so you guys can enjoy the scenery, the beauty, everything, okay?
Whoa, look at this. Look at this. Okay.
I'm gonna clean the lens real quick, don't mind. I do clean up after myself, by the way. If he poops, I got a bunch of poop bags, all right? Good morning, everybody. Easy. Oh, this one is big. I almost got close to this. Salala. I'm so happy he likes the beach. I didn't even know this. I had this guy for 4 years now. I didn't know he loved the beach. Oh man. My mistake, Zalala. I mean, you know how dogs get excited when they're like, you know, they know the route to the dog park, when they're going to the dog park? He gets amped up when he goes to the dog park. Now, the same energy, like I said earlier, when he goes to the beach. Zalala, this way. Oh man, something in my eye, sand. I'll pick it up, guys. Look at this. I'm all about environmental friendly stuff, okay? Don't mind the camera. Hey, watch it out. You know, I sometimes even pick up litter, man. I am my brother's keeper. I don't know if that makes sense. Take a break.
Look at him.
Now he's gonna start biting the water. After this, I'm gonna do 10K as usual. I always bring my dog here to enjoy the water. Let him do
Zalala, come here, over here.
To do his thing, and after that, I need to give him my endorphins. Look at him trying to fight the water. That's how I get my morning endorphins. Running is my therapy. You know, without running, I don't know where I'll be. I'm telling you now, man, my anxiety went down when I started running. Like, you know, I'm a business owner. You guys know I'm a dog trainer. I rehabilitate dogs. And there's always a lot of stress on my mind, a lot of decision making that I have to do. And all the, they got you, Zalala. You guys saw him trying to bite that? All of that, you know? I get clarity. You get mental clarity, man. So for those of you, take a break. Good boy. For those of you who can't afford psychiatrists, run. Oh my God, he's so happy. Good boy. He loves the beach. Yo, we're coming to the beach a lot. Come on. Get it. Good boy.
Look at this guy.
Like yesterday, I think it wasn't yesterday. Ooh, that's a big one, Zalala. Get out of there. Good boy. Yesterday? Not yesterday. Yesterday was Christmas. The day before that. Salam. Come in. The day before that, I was here with Zalalem, and a seal, a big seal. I took a video of it. I'll post it. A seal was just staring at us and Zalalem as if Zalalem was lunch. I was so scared. Good boy, Papa. Good boy. But, Zalalem. But you know, I do not want to get these shoes wet. These are my running shoes. There's nothing worse than running with the wet shoes. Zalalem. Zalalem, come over here. Show the people how you like the water. All right, I'm gonna shut up, guys. I know some of y'all use this as a meditation. I'm gonna shut up. Oh, this is the biggest one. This was the biggest one. It got Zalala. I'm trying to shut up, guys, but sorry. I had my coffee, you know. Good boy.
What is he doing?
He's like jumping. He's so happy, dude. Oh my god. To see your dog this happy. Zalalem, Zalalem. Come on. Trying to get wet, guys. Oh my god! Zalalem, come here. That's too big, fam. That's too big. Look at this. Whoa. Whoa. Look at that wave. Look at that. Zalalem. Eight-minute video already. Yeah, man. I used to never do this. I used to never come to the beach until I got a dog, man. Like, you have to understand. You know, once you're aware of death, that one day, you know, you won't be here, then you try to live, you don't know, all of a sudden you stop to hesitate, to make decisions, to go on that vacation, to do whatever that's necessary, you know, to enjoy life, to enjoy life. Like, I used to be like, I'm tired, I'd rather sit at home. I stopped all of that, man. I stopped. Zalalem, come here. I stopped doing all of that. Each day, I try to enjoy life, man. I'm like, oh, I'm going there. Oh, it's my day off. I'm going here. I'm going there. Guys, you have to, even, you know, for those of you who are scared to make life decisions, you have to understand, you are already naked. You know, meaning, you know, you're not going to live forever. you're not gonna live forever. So the worst is gonna happen already. Like, whatever it is that's weighing you down, right? Whether life problems, whether good boy, whether, you know, just whatever it is, family problem, relationship, money problem, whatever it is that you're scared to make decision of, way worse than that is gonna happen already, you know? You already make it, you know? You are gonna be gone already, you know? One day you'll be gone, then, you know, it's like the worst is gonna happen. So it's like, if the worst is gonna happen, then it shouldn't be a big deal. You can't compare it to the things that makes you worried. You know what I'm saying? Sorry, that didn't make sense. But what I'm trying to say is, the worst is gonna happen already. So nothing can be worse than death, right? Now, don't fear death, you know, because think about it. What if you're like, oh, you're gonna live forever? There's no scary thing than that. Like, you know, that's a trap. That's a trap, right? That's what, you know, death implies life. That's what makes life so amazing, is that each day is a special one, because, you know, at one point it will go away, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, if you're gonna live forever, then there's no point of doing anything, because you always have tomorrow. So that's one thing I wanted to go ahead and say. But yeah, the sun is almost up. I have to do my 10K. I hope everyone is in good spirit and good vibe. You know, I want to make sure everybody is, you know, doing the best I can to live in this world, to be happy, you know, to, you know, the most important thing I always say is I make a video of this, but the most important thing people need to understand is that in order to you know, stay connected with yourself, to find your true passion, first you have to be healthy. What I mean by that is, if you're not healthy, then you're not gonna feel good, right? Like right now, the reason why I started running is to function in the most optimal way possible. And if you function in the most optimal way possible, your body's healthy, you're meditating, your mind is healthy, you're gonna feel good. And if you feel good, you're gonna go inner. You're gonna go deeper to search yourself. And then if you search yourself, you're gonna find your passion. If you find your passion, then, you know, you find your calling. Then it's like, with me, dog training, right? That's how I found it. I got healthy first. Once I got healthy, I felt good about myself. I felt good about myself, I went deeper inside myself. Once I went deeper inside myself, then I found my passion, and then life makes sense. Life has a meaning, okay? So for those of you who are looking to, I'll make another video on this, but if you're lost in life, lost in thought, lost on so many, you know, different things that you don't know what to do, you don't know what you're supposed to be, first get healthy. I know it's like, you know? Trust me, you get healthy first. You get healthy, feel good about yourself. Once you feel good about yourself, once you feel good about yourself, you're gonna wanna go deeper about yourself, right? You're gonna start looking within. Once you start looking within, like Carl Jung said, he who looks outside dreams, but he who looks within awakens. So you have to look within. And the way you do that is through health first. Okay? All right, I'm rambling. Peace, guys. I'm gonna go. And we'll see you guys next week. Oh, yeah, yeah. Salado. Salado. Look at him. Look what I'm gonna do, Salado. Salado. Hey. Salado. Hey. Okay, good boy. All right, bye-bye. Let's go, buddy. Think of my boy running all like. Okay, guys. 15 minutes video already. I'm out. Peace.